Okay, good morning everybody, and welcome to day two of Crufts, and welcome to the main arena. We've got a fantastic program ready for you for the rest of the day. So we're going to start with the agility, as you can see. We're going to start with the ABC jumping. So we need a judge. David Isbista is our first judge of the day. So ladies and gentlemen, let's give him a big round of applause. Thank you very much. So like I said, we're starting with the ABC. Now, what that means is anything but a collie. So we're going to see lots of different breeds. And the reason for that is that collies do tend to dominate agility. So it's really, really nice to see these other dogs having a go. And let me tell you, they do it fantastically as well. So our first handler is ready on the line. Getting a little warm up there. This is Jackie Ballantyne with Lyra, the lurcher. And kennel club name is the polar opposite, Agility Warrant Silver. Now, we have two parts to this competition. You're watching the jumping, that means that there's no agility equipment in the arena, and then what we're gonna do later on this afternoon is bring in the dog walk, the A-frame and the seesaw, and we're gonna add the results together and we're gonna come up with an overall winner. So, here we go, down to the wall. Just saw the weaves there, but we're turning right into the weave poles now. We've got three to go. Come on, Lyra, let's give them a big round of applause. Through the tyre, over the jump, and it's our first clear round. Well done, 36.249, and that goes into the lead. So that's a great start, isn't it? Our first clear round. Okay, next on the line, Megan Mead. This is Robin. German Shorthaired Pointer. Very excited to be here, I think, by the sound of it. Down to the tunnel. And this is a rescue dog. Had three homes before Megan took her on. Nicely into the tunnel. Here we go, down the line. Wow, flying down there. Right turn into the weaves. Let's give them lots of encouragement, ladies and gentlemen. Two to go. One more, yes. 34.611. We have a new leader. Fantastic. Safe to say, I think Megan's very pleased with that run. Okay, here we go. Debbie Hedges on the line with Zachary, Hungarian Vistler, Toddy's Red Hot Ginger. First time at Crufts. So all our dogs and handlers have competed throughout the year to qualify to run here. Debbie just checking the course there. Back into the tunnel. Over the Crufts jump into the tunnel. Here we go, down the line. Dogs. Stretching out lovely down there. Right turn, we call that a wing wrap. That tight turn. Here we go, let's give a big cheer. Yes, well done. 35.477. Goes into second. And great start to the day. This makes the agility run very, very exciting, by the way, later on, because it means our handlers will really have to push for that overall spot. So here we go, Isabel Austin. This is Willow, the Labrador. Joe Ronell Pooch, if I've got that right. And Izzy is a junior handler as well. We watched the YKC final here last night. There's a YKC dedicated ring, so make sure you go and watch all the events up there as well. It's a great organisation for young dog handlers or dog lovers. You don't even have to have a dog to be a member. So down to the wall, turning right. On number 16, I think that is. Through the weeds, lovely, well done. Yes, what a lovely finish. 35.334. No faults, goes into second place. Okay, this is Angela Owens and Logan, the lurcher, Mr. Logan Berry. This is a rescue lurcher. Nicely into the tunnel. You'll see our hand is swapping sides continually as the course changes direction. And what they're trying to do is get the fastest line, obviously with the least amount of force. So try to cut those turns out as much as possible and keep the dog flowing. That's key as well, because that means you get more speed. Oh, saw the wheeze, but gets a refusal there. So five faults. Just clocked the wheeze as she was going past, but that's okay. 36.154. So next to go, Alison Pell. This is Leah, the Malinois, Gold Mallee Innocent Eyes. And whilst Leah enjoys her agility, she says she saves her fifth and sixth gears for chasing bunnies. So, through the tunnel, back over the cross jump, round the loop. Swapping sides again as we go back into the tunnel. Over the cross jump, we're going, oh, she just saw that as a signal to come round the jump. So we're on five, that's a refusal. Right turn, telling the dog in the tunnel that it's going to be turning right. Another right turn on the wing wrap into the weaves. Come on, Leah. Oh, just picked up five there. Just getting a bit distracted now. You're going to notice that our judge is not marking the second fault there. That's because you can only be marked once you're in the weaves. So, well done. Total, I think it was 10 faults in the end. And it looks like some time faults up there as well. So 55.548 was the end result there. Goes into sixth place. So next is Jibs, the Whippet, with Nigel Staines. Morgan's Black Panther is the full kennel name. So here we go, into the tunnel. Nigel encouraging Jibs around the course. Into the tunnel again. Doesn't do many runs a year, this dog. He's 8 years old. But going nicely down to the wing wrap. Here we go, into the weaves. Come on, Jibs. Let's have a fast finish. Come on, Nigel. One to go. Through the tyre. Well done. Lovely run. 40.824. Well done. Goes into fifth place. So next on the line, we've got a noisy Labrador by the sound of it. This is Sarah Moorcroft with Milo. The Black Sheep is his full kennel name. Been competing for 3 years, first agility dog. Into the tunnel. Left turn. Signaling there to pick up that jump. It's quite what we call a flat angle, so the dog can't see it. It's not obvious to the dog. Into the tunnel. Right turn. Down the long line. Thought he was going to refuse that, but nicely done. Nicely through the weaves. Come on, Milo. One to go. Well done. It's a clear round. 39.096. And that goes into fifth place. Well done. So next to go, Sarah Weller with Maisie. And this is a Rotty Cross. Maisie Mumina of Ammonhithe. Anvahar. Anvahar says on here. Is that that's how you pronounce that? So another rescue dog. Down to the tunnel. That's a nice turn into the tunnel again, pushing out to that far jump. Crossing sides again. Here we go, over the cross jump. Directing her all the way, giving her lots of verbal command.
Oh, got another turn in, another blind turn to approach the weaves on the other side. Nicely through there. Two to go. One more. Yes, well done. 35.932. On a clear round, goes into fourth place. Well done. Well done, you. So, Sarah Thomas is on the line with Vinyasa. This is a Whippet, Vinyasa Blue Diamond. Been in agility for 3 years. We don't see many Whippets. I know we've seen two here today, but we don't see many Whippets in agility. So it's lovely to see something completely different in agility. Nice left turn. She seems like she's enjoying herself as we come out of the tunnel, down this long line. Nice turn into the weaves. Come on, Vinyasa. Three to go. Stay in the weaves. Lovely. Two to go. Through the tyre. Well done. 38.395. Clear round goes into sixth. Well done. Okay, so as you can see, all the equipment's now being lowered because we are on to the mediums. And all the dogs in agility are measured so that we know that they're jumping a height appropriate to their size. It's the same competition, ladies and gentlemen, so they will be competing against the existing score chart that's up on the cube at the moment, so we can see 34.611 is the time to beat. So our judge has just checked the course and checked that all the heights are right. He's happy, so looks like we're ready to go. So first on the line, we've already seen him once. This is Nigel Staines with Zico Morgan's Golden Eagle Agility Warrant Gold, and Nigel bred this dog, I believe. Down into the tunnel. Nigel running to get the turn in. Wants to block the path there of the dog so that it gets a nice turn into the tunnel. Into the tunnel again. Racing again to get that same turn. Nicely done. Into the tunnel. So here we go. Down that long line. Right turn. Into the weaves. Saying go weave. Encouraging her through there. Well done, Nigel. Another lovely run. 36.985. And that goes into the lead. Well done. Well done. That's a great place to be for the rest of the day. Okay, this is Darcy. Darcy's on the line with Abby Storer. And he's a cross. So this is a Cocker Spaniel crossed with a poodle. So a cockapoo, becoming more popular. La Belle Sauterelle is the name. First dog that Abby has had, and says that they've learnt agility together. First time at Crufts. So, here we go, flying down that line. Right turn. Into the weaves. Wow, look at that. Very nicely through there. Two to go. Another lovely run. Well done. 38.312 goes into second place. Wow. I'll tell you, the agility is going to be fun later because with all these clear rounds, everybody is going to have to be going for it. So that's fantastic. Sets us up for a fantastic competition. So Karen Gibbons on the line with Willow, the Shetland Sheepdog, Riverbend Mitzi. And this is the eighth time Willow has been here. And she says this is going to be her last year at Crufts. So running to get the turn in, blind turning it, down the line. Come on, Willow. Right turn. Oh, lovely. Right the way through the weaves there. Two to go. Well done. It's a cracking finish. 35.584. Taking the top spot. We have a new leader. So Willow is next with James Adams. Devon Gem Tis Gold Standard. And we're off. Working Cocker Spaniel. Wow, that was a good turn out of the tunnel. Wow, we're flying on this one. Okay, into the tunnel. Cutting those turns down. Wow, that was an amazing turn. Gosh, very athletic that was. Left turn, lovely turn, lovely turn. No time wasted, flying down. Okay, looking to beat. 36, I believe, on the clock. Wow, swapping sides again. Two to go, he's gonna smash it. Wow. 30.290. I think he just took 6 seconds off the leader. Oh my word. Wow. 30.290. That was quick, wasn't it? Goodness me. And James was so athletic, all that. Changing sides and everything. Amazing. Right, here we go. Lindsay Bentley's on the line. This is Nancy, Bedlington Terrier Cross Whippet, Brookhouse Danger Mouse. First time at Crufts again. She's going for it as well. Wow, this is quick as well. We need good lines on this type of course. You don't want to get in the dog's way. You just need to let it flow. Here we go, into the tunnel. Cutting down those turns, into the tunnel. Down the line, she's done a blind turn there. This is looking good as well. 3 seconds if she wants to challenge James. Oh, just came out of the weave. So picks up 5 faults, has to go back and complete them. If she had carried on, she would have been eliminated. But note now that our judge is not judging the extra faults there. So we're on 5, 46.089. So, Bly Fox is on the line with Rue, the working Cocker Spaniel. A noisy one. Devon Gem Golden Moment. Into the tunnel. Oh, that was lucky. Nearly deviated off the line there, but good dog to take the jump. Down to the tunnel. Blythe able to send her from a different distance there. Into the tunnel again. Blythe getting ahead to get as much acceleration as she can down the line. Right turn. Nice. Distance handling there. Lovely. It's another great run. Ooh, very close. 31.189 goes into second place. Wow, this is a great competition, isn't it? Very exciting. Okay, so now Tony Dawkins with Tiger, Mini American Shepherd, Bacheru Cross My Heart. And this little dog is hyper 24/7. It's like a little rocket. So down the line, sending her from a distance. Nice. Get in the tunnel there. Right turn. Into the tunnel again, sending from a distance so that she can pull into the tunnel. Here we go, down the line, trying to get ahead, but I think Tiger's gonna beat her. Into that wing wrap. Here we go, lovely, through the weeds. Wow, ladies and gentlemen. Come on, let's give them some applause. Wow, 29.835, wow. 0.2 of a second at least knocked off James's time. Wow. That was quick. That was quick. Oh, goodness me. Right, Nicola Garrett's next. This is Zed, the Shetland Sheepdog, 6 years old, Obey One Crazy Dude. Ladies and gentlemen, you have got to be here for the agility. That's all I can say. Into the tunnel. Right, left turn into the tunnel. Calling out of the tunnel, right turn, down the line. Here we go, into the weeds. Come on, Zed. Let's give a big round of applause. 2 to go. Well done, 34.159 goes into fourth place. So, 2 dogs to go. So, we're on at 29-ish to beat. Next online is Molly Phillips with Kaiser, another miniature American Shepherd dog. He's six today, so it's his birthday. Happy birthday, Kaiser. Starry Tales, Little Chief. Into the tunnel. Down that line. Left turn. Down the line. Into those weaves. Come on, Kaiser. Yes, well done. Two to go. Let's give them a big round of applause. 32, 4, 3, 5 goes into fourth place. Well done. So the last to go. Last in this competition of the ABCs. So Erin Inverarity, I hope I've said that right, with Sam. Erin's Delight is the dog's full name. The second time they've been here in the main arena at Crufts. And have represented Scotland in international competition. And are going to do so again this year. So right turn, into the tunnel. Down the line, running fast as she can down there. Going to go left. Crossing sides again to pull her into the weeds. Nicely done, very nicely done. Here we go. Two to go. One more. Well done, Erin. 34.072 goes into fifth place. Wow. Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes the ABC. That was really, really exciting. What a great competition. Let's give them all a round of applause because I thought that was fabulous. Really fabulous. So make sure you come back and watch the agility. And we are very shortly going to go on to the presentation. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's give them a really huge round of applause. I think it was a fabulous competition there. Ladies and gentlemen, it's presentation time. Okay, so we are going to go to the large first. And in first place, well done, it was Megan Mead with Wreck-It Robin. In second place was Portia Jana with Isabel Austin. Sorry, I'll correct that. John and L. Portia is the dog's name. Well done, Isabel. And in third place was Debbie Hedger with Toddy's Red Hot Ginger.
Okay, and on to the mediums then. In first place was Tony Dawkins with Bocero, Cross My Heart.
Thank you very much.
On to second place, it was a fabulous run, James Adams with Devon Gem, Tis Gold Standard. And taking third was Blythe Fox with Devon Gem, Golden Moment.
Well, I'm quite fantastic. Good luck to you guys.
So, ladies and gentlemen, let's give them a big round of applause as they take their lap of honour.
What Leo loves is to be able to get to know a patient. You know, we walk down the corridor and people say, hello, gorgeous, and he looks up, and I'm sure he thinks his name is gorgeous at times. I'm Lindsay Uglow. I'm the lead therapy dog handler of the team that visits Southampton Children's Hospital. SCH Therapy Dogs is Southampton Children's Hospital Therapy Dogs, so we're a team of 6 therapy dogs and 4 handlers.
The minute Lindsay and the dogs walk on, people switch off, people have time to relax. The patients that are awake absolutely love the treat of having a dog. It's somebody who's non-clinical can come in and just offer them something that we can't as staff. They bring a bit of home into the unit, into what is a really clinical, intense environment.
I knew nothing of his diagnosis or his condition, and then it was suggested that maybe I should introduce the dog to Oscar.
Lindsay brought Leo over, put his paw onto Oscar's bed, and instantly his heart rate dropped and we got a smile. And it was a miracle, it really was.
If we can give them that little bit of magic to cling onto, then that's really great. That smile meant a lot to everybody. All of what we do comes under animal-assisted intervention. So within that, there's animal-assisted activity, which is meet and greet. They'll go and say hello to everybody. They're like speed daters. If we're doing an escort, or if we're supporting a child who's having a particular procedure done, we might be sitting with that parent and child for 40 minutes. And it's all about keeping the child with a positive thought process whilst they're having healthcare.
Leo just comes into the unit, he's such a chilled dog. Just having that calming time, just patting Leo, is just therapy for us all.
They're greeted by people from the minute we walk in the door to the minute we leave. He will trot in like he's owning the place, but to try and get him to leave on occasion, I've actually had to carry him out. The dogs just come in and their friendly faces, they give them something other than the healthcare environment to think about. They're not there to persuade or cajole the children, they're just simply dogs. And we are the bridge between the healthcare team and the child.
Because we've been through so much and we've gone through such a traumatic event, I think we've formed a lifelong friendship that will never be changed. I am PC Louise McMullen and this here is retired police dog Wolfie. Specialist told me that I would never be an operational police officer again, not only a dog handler. I wasn't going to listen to that because I'm quite stubborn and was adamant I was going to get back.
She just kept like striving and making little steps at a time, and it was quite a long journey really for her. Just showed that desire, like I am not going to be told I can't do it.
So with the support of West Midlands Police and my inspector at the time, I managed to get back to being a fully operational dog handler.
Wolfie and her immediately connected. As soon as they got together, it's as if they'd been together as from puppies. I think they only did a 2-week rehandle course and then went out back out on the streets operational.
I must have been knocked out. And my initial thoughts were, as I opened my eyes, was seeing the flames because the car had caught fire. I injured my wrist, fractured eye socket, fractured jaw, and I also sustained quite bad injuries to the centre of my back. As I was crawling out the car, my only concern was that I had to get the dog out the back of the vehicle.
I got there, I could still see some smoke or steam billowing. Louise was on the floor with Wolfie.
I just knew that I had to get him to the vets because I thought he would die.
He's not just a dog, he's a colleague to us. Not shy to say that it was emotional.
I was in hospital then, just being apart and not able to be near him was horrible. He had to be carried out of the vets. He couldn't walk. He had hydrotherapy. He also saw a physiotherapist there. He's also helped me because I had a bad back and I was limited in how much I could do walking. So the two of us together must have been a right sight to see. Wolfie passed his license again in the May 2019.
And they proved that they were very capable of going back out there and going back out on the streets. However, Louise quickly identified some of Wolfie's behaviours, that he wasn't actually happy in the vehicle.
We had a really busy set of night shifts and I think it took him back to that November. We put it down to the fact that Wolfie is suffering from post-traumatic stress. Events such as the accidents that we've been through not only affects us, but it also affects them. My instant decision was to retire him from police work. Our friendship has grown even more in the fact that we spend more quality time together now, I think. It's sometimes nice to sit, have that companionship and that affection and love from them to make you smile.
Ellie is my absolute life. She's just my rock for everything. She is just my constant sidekick. I probably wouldn't be here, to be honest, if it weren't for Ellie. My name's Hayley and this is my dog, Ellie. When it happened, it just felt like my world just falling apart. We was all sitting here as a family and she went upstairs and she said she'd be back down for lunch and she never did. We were best friends and she was my biggest support network and she was my idol. All my family had someone to talk to and someone to share their grief with and I didn't. Not have her there in my life, I just thought I just can't do life without her. Ellie stepped up straight away afterwards. She was my rock and she just followed me everywhere. Our bond just grew stronger. She just stuck by me. Like she knew what was going on. She just would put her head on my lap if I was feeling sad at the time. If I just wanted to cry, she'd be there with me. She just lay by my side. It was like she was saying that everything was going to be okay. Ellie was my motivation to get up in the morning. She was my motivation to get out of bed and get dressed, even if it was just to come and feed her. But she'd get me up, she'd get me walking, which in turn got me socialising straight away and talking about what happened. And she got me back to what I love doing, which is agility and Hillworks music. We go agility once a week and we train Hillworks music every day. We train tricks at home, whether it be out in the park or in the living room. When I'm training with her, it's like I forget about everything around me. We go to compete every couple of weeks or so. We go to local competitions with agility and we travel up and down the country for Hillworks music. When we go to shows, it's like being in a bubble, just me and Ellie. Nothing in the world matters. It's just me and her spending time together, training and enjoying ourselves. Being able to take home a rosette, it's good to be able to look back and see the journey we've taken together. Ellie was the reason I carried on my activities such as agility and Hillworks music. She just gave me something to aim for in life. I owe Ellie my life. because she's just one incredible dog.
Without Jovi, life was a bit of a struggle. I've never had a dog quite like Jovi before. He is definitely one of a kind. So I'm Graham Sage, and this is my hearing dog, Jovi. So I started to lose my hearing at about 15, 16 years old. I did used to miss things like fire alarms and wake up alarms and cooker alarms and all of those sort of things that could cause safety issues. Sitting in an environment where you've got lots of people around you, but you feel alone because you can't get involved in the conversation because you're just not able to pick up what's being said. That also meant that I was keeping a bit to myself. My wife had heard about hearing dogs and recommended it. And I sent in an application and it all kicked off from there. When I've got him, everyone is a lot more aware of that need to speak directly to me. Even if it's a conversation with someone else, they will speak clearer so I would understand. It really lit up our eyes as to how beneficial he really was. The boys love having him in the classroom, I must admit. Yeah, and they just have that sort of family feel when they're in the classroom. He's definitely helped the way that I teach and helped me understand the children better and the children understand me better. And he can alert me to when the boys are trying to communicate with me, but I'm not necessarily hearing what they're saying or anything. They can call him to them and then come and get me. If I've got an activity for the boys to go on, I can put a timer on and he'll come and alert me when their time's up. So at home, he can wake me up to the alarm. He alerts me to the doorbell. I'm so grateful that I've been introduced to him and you know, the sort of things that he does for me, not just the actual work side of it, you know, how he alerts me to all of these things, but the social side of it. Since getting him, it's been a big change.
I think because the dire situation we knew she was in at the time, we all felt the same. Whenever we went back to that area, we wanted to check on Barry. I'm Sean Laidlaw, and this is my rescue dog, Barry. Before I found Barry, I was kind of lost in life. I'd left the military. I was kind of lost in civilian life. I didn't really know who I was, what I was, and losing that identity as a soldier was kind of hard. Like, I was struggling that bad that it was to the point where I thought, I don't want to be here anymore. I hit the reset button, and to me, normality was war. So I took a contract out in Syria to disarm bombs out there. We'd had our morning routine done. We'd driven in, parked up to a place that we'd been to before. We just heard a noise, a screaming noise. And then there was this kind of concrete plinth, and that's where Barry was, just kind of caught in there. I said to him, right, let's get her back, then let's go get her. So at the end of the day, once we finished our jobs, yeah, we'll just pick her up and we'll take her with us. One of my issues, I don't really think before I do, so I got her back to camp and one of the guys turned to me and said, like, you've got a puppy. We have no puppy food. We have like all these things that you need to care for a puppy, like even like wee pads and things like that. Everyone brought something to the table. The chefs were bringing dry Kellogg's as kibble. We had some of the dog handlers were donating us some food. We had an American SEAL team that just turned up on our doorstep one day. Like, this is really weird. Like, we're in the middle of this war zone and you've got someone like knocking on your front door to come play with your dog. So it really distracted everyone from the harsh realities of what we were living in. I went to Syria kind of broken and not really knowing where I was in life and really on a knife edge of where I wanted to be on this earth. And it wasn't until maybe week two of having Barry that I realised I hadn't had any thoughts. I hadn't had an outburst or anything like that. She'd really kept me calm. And I think that was when I first realised the effect that she was having on me. I I never got to say that goodbye, and that kind of really started to frustrate me. They were gonna leave the camp, and Barry had no home. So instantly, I had to come up with a plan. Luckily enough, I was already talking to a charity called War Paws. To try and get a dog out was really difficult. So we actually ended up smuggling her inside of a fruit basket through the checkpoints. And as soon as she got through the border at the other end in Iraq, War Paws were there. They grabbed her straight away and took her away. Everyone assumes that at the airport it was going to be this big, romantic, fairy tale ending where she comes running up to me and jumps at me like you see in all the American like YouTube videos. And it was nothing like that. I even expected it to be like that, and it wasn't like that at all. I'd been getting sent progress pictures every now and then, so I knew she was growing, but I didn't realise how big she was until she came out of that cage. She just was looking at me, like, who is this? And then I got her to sit, and I knelt down next to her, and she stiffed my leg. And I started stroking her head, and I think that's where it kind of clicked. And she just like barrel rolled onto the floor, and I had a pause in the air. As crazy as it sounds, I just sit there and talk to her. She doesn't judge, she just sits there and wants to be loved. She was the exact same as when I left her, really. A little diva that loves attention, and that's just who she is. When I come home, everyone was saying, oh, it's great that you've rescued Barry, and there was no way that I rescued her. She definitely rescued me. I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for her.
And ladies and gentlemen, a very good morning. Welcome back to the main arena here at Crofts. Our next competition, it's going to be Fast and Furious, I reckon, also like the previous one, which I must admit, from a spectator's point of view, I watched that and I loved it. And I think we're going to love this one as well. First of all, we need our judge. And put your hands together, please, for the one and only Mr. Martin Cavill. Travels around the world judging nowadays. Renowned for his judging abilities. And we're going into the medium dogs, first of all. This is the Crofts singles. So we've got part one this morning and part two this afternoon, which is at 2 p.m. So if you want to look to the agility side of it, that's at 2 o'clock this afternoon. So it's the medium dogs. And first to go, we've got Shannon Springford, working gift, border collie, 6 years of age, and an agility champion. So Shannon doing the recall. She's up to two. And she's away. Okay, go the release command. Over the spread. Into the region tunnel. Into that tunnel. I'm going to pull back across now to the left. Nicely handled. But unfortunately, we've just lost the dog behind us there. We popped over number four. So we have an elimination. And obviously, she'll continue working. Look at that. Beautifully handled. Oh, beautifully done. So they're coming down the last three obstacles. Give them a big round of applause as they finish, please. Even though we've had an elimination, very unlucky there for Shannon and Gift. Next to go, we've got Leslie. Leslie Pecker working with Nikki. Dog's 5 years of age. A feisty little dog who enjoys barking, tugging and agility. 2019, she won a reserve champ ticket, the final agility round of the British Open. And has been selected for GB agility squad. And at the moment, they're flying. They are literally flying around. Nicely handled again, pulls the dog away from that spread. We're in the tunnel. We're on to number 10. Oh, she turned around, the dog wasn't there. Guess where it had gone down the tunnel. So we've got an elimination. We obviously knew where the finishing line was. Unlucky. So one lucky there for Leslie and Nikki. Next to go, Hannah Thorpe, working Izzy, border collie, cross miniature poodle, 5 years of age. First time they qualified the British Open and singles, and excited to be competing in the main arena. Izzy also loves playing with her squeaky toys. Ah, I remember this one from yesterday. Now this one, this dog taught my eye. Main reason being it has a similar problem to me. It's got longish hair. When it's windy, when it's running, it goes everywhere. And as you can see, once the head goes down, those ears are going back, the hair's going back, the dog's fired up. There's a lot of verbals going on here, but it's working, it's working. And they're running smoothly down towards number 17. Turning around into those weeds. We need a nice entry, and we've got a nice entry. We've got three to go. We've got two to go. One to go. 33.98 taking the lead for Hannah and Izzy. So next to go, we've got Liz Carpenter from Leeds, working Winnie. Collie cross poodle, 4 years of age. This will be our first crufts. Winnie has won two reserve champs tickets and gained a place on the KC Agility Team GB squad. She absolutely loves her agility. There you go. So Liz and Winnie are off. One of these dogs that jumps into the ridging tunnel. Nicely commanded there. Again, keeping the dog away from the spread. We don't want the dog popping around again. Another elimination. Out, she says. Dog goes out beautifully. Pulling around out again into this tunnel, ridging tunnel, coming down to the centre of the arena. Pulls the dog through. Now to number 17. Well, we've got three to go. This is looking good at the moment. I don't like to say too much as they're coming towards the end. But here we go. We've got two to go. We've got one to go. Superb run. Got into first place with 33.387. Not a lot between that and the previous leader. So we should have Natasha Chambers next, working Indy, Sheltie Cross Collie, 6 years of age. Dream agility dog, calm and collected whilst waiting our turn. Then crazy the moment you say go. A once in a lifetime dog. Don't you believe it, you'll have another one. There's always one out there. So we've got the go command. Heads down, rapid start. That was a cross to number three. Got another one jumping into the rigid tunnel. Survives what you can see from a commentary point. You can just see it from where I am. They're flying. They're out to number 11 already. Pushes the dog out, pulls back in now, turning around towards the rigid tunnel with a speed section down the middle. Ooh, a little bit of time lost there, possibly a little bit to the left. We're into the weaves. Sweeping entry into the weaves. Nice set of weaves again. Are we in for another clear? Here we go. Time coming up. 32.161. And they go into first place as well. Oh my word. It's Joe's the next. Joe Gleed, working Edge, Cocker Spaniel, 4 years of age. Second time at Crufts, loves his agility, but also loves chasing his ball, running through water and sleeping on the sofa. Why not? He's very cheeky and naughty, but has the best personality. So Joe working way away there, saving her legs. Ooh, well held, well held. So a little wide on some of the turns. We're losing a little bit of time. It's not running as flowing, I would imagine, as Joe would like it to. They only need a clear. Basically, they've got a second part this afternoon at 2 o'clock, which is the agility round. They ideally need a clear, preferably in the top four or five, maybe. Which, by the looks of it, they're going to get. 35.211, so we will see it later on. But they need a clear this morning to make sure they can try and get through to the final this afternoon, unless there's faster clears, of course. Next to go, Ashley Butler, working Eliza, bearded collie, 6 years of age. Only started competing together last year. They're very proud to be running at Crufts together this year. First time, and I'm sure she will love the atmosphere. That's Eliza, obviously. We see Ashley on a regular basis. So, nice flight. Start to run there with a lovely turn from three. Again, blocking the obstacle. Wide on the turn there, possibly coming out of the rigid tunnel, but we're all right, we can make that time up. And so we need a clear, that's the main thing. So into the tunnel.
Close. Nice. Go weebies.
We've got three to
weebies,
go.
Weebies. Yes. Weebies.
Your weebies commands going through. We want to go. Come on, Ashley. 32.9. We've got the second place for Ashley and Eliza. So, Rebecca's next. Rebecca Sargent, working Dolly Collie. I like that name, Dolly Collie. Border Collie, 11 years of age, agility champion. You know what they say. I love this dog so much it makes me cry. Last time on the green carpet, she is the gin to my tonic and the ice to my Baileys. I've never heard that before and I really like it. There you go. Gin to your tonic. And nice to your babies. So, Rebecca and Dolly. They're away. Nice change there, like that. Just out of the tree again. Into the tunnel.
Come here, Dolly!
No problem with the wall there. flowing nicely at the moment. Nice, we've got three to go. It's gone quiet in the arena. Hopefully it's going to erupt in a minute. Nice looking run with two to go. Oh! 5 points up in there for Rebecca McDonald. So, two to go in the mediums. Only two to go now. Dalton Meredith's next with Munchie, Border Collie, 4 years of age. Another agility champion. Dog trainer from Ringwood. Munchie's bred by Alan Lamerton and is from the line Fabidozzi Border Collies. Munchie is one of two dogs I run, the other being her sister. Munchie lives life to the full and is a crazy little dog with a big heart. This is almost like Dalton's in front there. Just kind of catch me if you can where he needs to. Slow down. And look at him wide turning. We had a look at those weaves. We did have a look, but we're all right. We've lost probably a second and a bit there, I would think. But they're flowing nicely the wide down now to number 17, the Cruft Circle. And we're in the weeds. This is another nice run so far, although we've got to be careful what I say. Well done, Dalton and Munchie into fourth place. So, our last medium dog to go, Dawn Weaver, working Vegas, Collision, Collie, Cross, Papillon. Vegas is a dog in a million. He takes care of all my other dogs and is a dream dog to run. So loyal, honest and loving in every way. The other dogs really rely on him 100% and so do I. So, Dawn in Vegas. A bit of a shuffle. Either that, they've got an inch. Right, we're away. Nice steady start. It's picking up, coming around in a rigid tunnel. Definitely picking up now with a bit of wheel spin as we went into the second of the tunnel. Ooh, speed's there, you can see it. We're just losing a little bit of traction, but we're all right. Bit of a wide turn to that rigid tunnel. Coming down to 17. And it's the last of the mediums. We need a big round of applause for this one, without a doubt, as we come across the finishing line, hopefully with a clear round. Yes! 32-4-2-5-2 in second place for Dawn in Vegas. So what we're doing now, as you can see, we're the ring party. What a great job they do as well. They deserve a big round of applause, the ring party. They're here for 4 days, putting the jumps up, down, building courses, putting out flyball equipment, sticking down things with tape, you name it, they do it. So the jumps, obviously, you can see now going up to the for the large dogs. And if you want to watch part two of this one, it's on at 2 o'clock this afternoon. So we've also got the Crufts team coming up following this competition. So the agility Crufts team medium final today. Good Citizens Dog Scream. We've got a break then. Heel work to music. Rescue dog agility. And then, as I say, at 2 o'clock, the Crufts singles heat, followed by the Crufts Large Novice and Medium ABC Final, followed by the Flyball Team Quarterfinals. Save your voices for that one. So, just checking, finalising. Obviously, the spread's got to be altered as well. What am I looking at? So Martin just putting the final touches there, just getting our camera set up as well, as you can see by the jumps. Gives you a better view than when you're live on the Crufts YouTube channel. Good morning, Sarah, if you're listening. So I'm just waiting there. I think we're all good to go. We are pretty much good to go. I'll introduce you to our first competitor. We've got Dave Munnings going first, working Fame, Border Collie, 8 years of age, agility champion. Fame has been an incredible dog, winning every fine in the UK and 2 medals at the FCI World Champs. This will be one of her last years at Crufts, so we will enjoy whatever happens. Great partnership, these two, as with all the pairs, to be honest, dog and them. Dog and handler, they make a great partnership. And this is flowing nicely at the moment for Dave, and also for Fame. So down to 17, we're turning around with 3 to go, we're in the weeds. Great weave entry, Dave hanging back, he's going to pick the dog up then and put the acceleration on to the finishing line. Super run, 31.805 for Dave and Fame. So, next in, we have Martin Reed from with Spring Border Collie, 7 years of age, another agility champion. As you can hear, a vocal spring. We're going to have a bit of a creep there. We're all right. We're just making sure we get a few feet closer to Dad.
Let's go.
So quiet handling, as you can see. Not a lot of verbal there. Just tell the dog where it needs to be as he comes at the top. Smooth, quiet. Widish turn there, Isaac. Just took the jump a bit to the left. So probably lost a bit of a second there. We're coming around with three to go into the weeds. We're coming down the weeds nicely with two to go. Come on, here we go. Over the finishing line. 30, oh, we're in a second. 33.154 for Martin in Spring. So Joanne's in next. Joanne Tristram, working Bright, Border Collie, 5 years of age. Bright's first time as an individual at Crufts. Jo's been before, of course she has. So Joanne and Bright. Away. Interesting turn. We went the other way then. I don't know whether that was planned, I've got to be honest. But it was okay. Vocal air from Bright. Out the command. A bit steady over that hurdle. We've dropped a pole, just picked up five fold. It's unlucky. Could still hopefully see you later on. You never know. We'll see you later on. Hopefully. In the weeds. A bit wrapped up on that one. But we're over the finishing line. Unlucky with the five fold. 35.161 for Joanne and Bright. Next to go in the large, we've got Joe Gleed, working Scooter, Border Collie, 6 years of age, another agility champion. This is Scooter's fourth time at Crufts. She loves agility the most, but also enjoys playing and watching the TV, especially the sports channels. She loves the crowd and likes to be cheered on, so have no problems about cheering on any of the dogs, to be honest. They're all used to it. They've been a lot of the job. They've been here before. They've been at other large events where there's plenty of noise. Thank you, Greg. Oh dear, never changed. He's going to be 30 years. Oh, unlucky there. We just got an elimination on this spread. That's a shame. Sends the dog on beautifully. Nice turn in the air as well. There you go. That's send away to your weave entry. So unlucky there for Joe and Scooter. We've got five faults. You never know. You never know. So he's only been here for 30 years. He's a bit of a fixture, Greg is. So we've got Greg next. Greg Derrick, working Addict, Border Collie, 6 years of age. Greg's 30th consecutive year competing at Crufts, and Addict's second. I remember watching him on Blue Peter, and I was only young then. He's younger than me. Those were the days. Nicola Garrett. That sounded quite good in the background, that did. So, Greg on the recall. And Addict's away. Oh, just clicked the long jump. Five faults in the long jump. Okay, another handler. Not a lot of verbals, but plenty of leg work. Plenty of leg work. So, coming around a 14. Would you tell? Ooh, that was tight. That was tight. We're in the leaves. We've got a five at the moment on the long jump. Greg pushing it down the finishing line. Well done. Unlucky there with a five for Greg and Addict. Into fourth place. Next in, we've got Charlene Illingworth, working Image, Border Collie, 7 years of age. Image became an agility champion last year. She seems to be the most unlucky dog. So we are super proud to achieve this status. Charm away, Image away.
Go, Image, go!
So plenty of go commands there, and then a steady when she needs it. Just rolled the pole, unfortunately. He picked up a five points there.
Image.
turning in the air right to the left hand side. Don't just if you get somebody wraps and tries to wrap around, that would save a little bit of time. It's probably a second there lost. Just got to drive on a weave entry. So 10 faults at the moment, unfortunately. Even two to go. Big round of applause for the shining image. Next scene, we've got Natasha Wise with Pebbles, Border Collie, 7 years of age. Pebbles loves the green carpet and competitions at Crofts. Third year in the championship at Crofts and with Pebbles. Fingers crossed for another successful one. We're also part of GB Agility team. We've gained bronze medal in the World Champs in Finland. And we're going to do gold next time. Right, very, very bold go command. And Pebbles is away. So is Matt, plenty of leg work. Over commands there, keep the log under control, obviously not taking any wrong obstacles. Sweeping turn around, getting round to number 12. Ridgy tunnel now, coming down with four to go. Weave entrance, no problem at all, they've got two to go after the weave, that's one side, we've got one to go, come on, that's yes! 32.519 goes into second place in the Natasha Pebbles. So, next to go at Sarah Blaken from Working Dream, Border Collie, 6 years of age. Do you know what? You couldn't kind of get that, could you? When you look from where I'm standing now, the dog came out of that tunnel and was literally going to the right of that obstacle. So unfortunately, we picked up an elimination there. That's the thing, sometimes a dog sees something, maybe something. We got pulled again that way then, that was interesting. We got back in the tunnel again and got pulled that way. You never know what they're going to see sometimes. Unlucky there with that one. It was a cracking run otherwise there from Sarah and Dream. So Dan's in next, Dan Shaw, Working Geek, Border Collie, 7 years of age, most perfect dog ever. Bronze medals at the Worlds, silver medal at the EAO, and won the Crufts Champ and British Open last year. Very, very quiet with his hand in. Very, very quiet. I don't know if you saw that turn from where I am. That just literally dog turned straight into that tunnel there. Lost no time whatsoever. It's that crucial split second that could make a difference between winning first place and so on.
Wait.
We've got two to go. Come on, Dan. Come on, Geek. 32.368. Goes into second place for Dan and Geek. Sean's back again with Agent, Border Collie, 4 years of age. Agent's a homebred boy, which makes him super special. He's an absolute dream, and I'm very lucky to have him. Second time at Crufts, he was selected in 2019 to be part of the Team GB's development squad. There you go. So we've got down to a stage, which is great, that our UK handlers, let's call them the top handlers, can now work. Get prepared for events in Europe and so on. And we're getting there, it's getting better all the time. So we picked up 5 faults, unfortunately, on the long jump.
Agent!
Jump over that wall from where I am. Nice turn, I'd saved a little bit of time. So we're coming around to 17 with just the 5 faults.
Weavies, yes.
We're in the weaves. Two to go for Sean and Ancient. Yeah, unlucky with the 5 faults. Super randomised. Next to go from Scotland. That's more like it. I'm glad you're all here now. Ewan Patterson on next with Crazy. Border Collie, 4 years of age. Member of Team GB and Team Scotland. Crazy won first place in the agility round at the FCI World Champs. This guy was amazing. I watched it online. Truly amazing run. So Ewan and Crazy. So Nice steady start at the moment. Good pace to it though, that's what I like. I like the pace. Not too much verbal. Bit of verbal there. So pushing around to 12. Flowing nicely at the moment there for Ewan and Crazy. Four to go over the KC hurdle. Two to go. Come on. Yes! 32 points. We're going to go first, we're going to third. 32.987. Jessica next, Jessica Clare here with Dora, working at the Malinois, 4 years of age. Fourth dog to compete at Crufts. This is Dora's first time. We're excited to be here competing. Nice to see a Malinois in the final as well, or in the final group. I'll bark and shriek. She knows how far to let him go, don't you worry. We've gone quiet then, interesting. We've just got to that certain distance. Big striding dog this one. And very fast as you can see. In fact, very, very fast. Run round, back into the tunnel. Sends the dog out. We need a good turn around 14. That's a nice turn. Didn't go much to the left on that one at all. Over 17, and we're turning round with three to go. I like this one. Oh, look at those weaves for a big dog. Wow, come on. Yes. Third place, 32.747 for Jessica and Dora. Lovely run. Next in, Dalton Meredith, working Costa, working sheepdog, 7 years of age. Dalton Meredith, dog training from Ringwood. Costa is my second agility dog, bred by myself. A long recall on this one. That's no movement at all, Arnie. Just the back end going up just before takeoff, as they say. Flowing nicely. Again, another quiet, relatively quiet handler. Plenty of hand commands, as in, ooh, that was a good one, wasn't it? We're going towards that spread, but we're all right. Corrected correctly, as they say.
Out
the command. A bit wide there, as you can see from where I am again.
Release.
Nice, release. Two to go. Come on, Dalton. Come on, Dalton. 33.344. Pops him into sixth place. So, Gemma's in next. Gemma Haycock, working jukebox, border collie, 4 years on Monday. This is Duke's first time competing at Crufts. Very excited to be competing with him in two events on the famous green carpet. So, Gemma and Duke. Fast start. That's a very fast start. Nice turn. And a stop, literally a stop and turn that was there. Wow. And we're getting excited. We're halfway around the course almost. Well, we've gone past halfway, haven't we? 17 with three to go. Gemma and Duke, can they make it clear round? Look at those wheeze fast again. We've got one to go. Yes, 33.353 into seventh place for Gemma and Duke. Next to go, we've got Martin Reed, wicked snooze, border collie, 3 years of age. So Martin and Sneeze, another recall again, literally from the far end of the arena, right in the corner. If you can't see the dog, you'll see it now. Here we go. We're away. Nice, quiet handling again. As you can see, hand, arm, shoulders, movement there, direction-wise for the dog's commands. A bit of a turn possibly there. Might have lost a split there, time-wise. Flowing lovely into that tunnel. Interesting, because he went the other side, didn't he? With a run past. We picked up five there, that's a shame. Unlucky there to Martin and Snooze. 5 volt with 37.562. And our last large competitor, then we're going to go down to the smalls. We've got Marita Davis with Duca, border collie, 3 years of age. This is Duca's second time at Crufts. Last year she became an agility champion and competed for Team GB at the EOs and the FCI World Champs. Whoa, big jump over that long jump. That was a big jump. Great turn into the rigid tail. Only saw the back end of the dog, the head was already in. So a bit of vocal there from Dugan, we can cope with that. A bit also from Rita. So, three to go, we're in the weeds. Great set, look at him, front legs go, wow, two to go, come on. Yes, 34.715 into eighth place there for Marita and Duca. Right, so now the times go down. Not really the times go down, the times hopefully will go down. They might be quicker than the large dogs, or the medium dogs, you never know. And the small dogs pop in to the arena. Always like them, if you were here yesterday you may have heard me say, I used to run small dogs myself many years ago, and large, and medium in loads of times. Always interesting to see if you can get a small dog to go around a course quicker than a large dog. And it quite often happens, to be honest. Quite often happens. Bigger striding, obviously, the larger dogs. This is a quick change around. The guys are doing a fantastic job, as usual. So don't forget, if you've enjoyed watching this one, which is obviously on now, you've also got the Crufts team following it, which is the medium final. So if you want a bit more agility, it's a team event with four dogs and four handlers, and a baton change is one of them kind of ones where hopefully they don't drop the baton. Well worth staying ringside to watch that as well. So the spread's been adjusted. The camera's been adjusted. They're being adjusted. Okay, it looks like we're good to go. Our first dog is ready on the line. We've got Nina Rajala with Tara Papillon, 3 years of age. Once in a lifetime dog, she's achieved so much regardless of only being 3.2 kg and at only 3 years of age, including silver medal at the IFCS, is in the GB squad 2020, and being at Crufts is a dream come true. There we go. So Nina and Tara are away. So if you look at the ground that's covering now compared to a large dog, they do a lot more work with the legs, obviously, but sometimes they're like a little pocket rocket. And this one certainly is. A bit like some of the mediums earlier on. And plenty of vocal as well. Again, as I keep saying, how do they run? How do they breathe? And they bark at the same time as well. Does make you wonder. It's that hype, that enjoyment. And at the moment, these two are absolutely, wow, they're flying. What's the time going to be like? 34.662. For Nina and Tara, cracking run. So next to go, we've got Chloe Brown working Thai Shetland Sheepdog, 8 years of age, competed this year at the European Opens and the World Champs for Team GB, competing in the YK Searing for many years. But this is my first time in the main arena, once in a lifetime dog, little and vocal. So Chloe and Thai away. So, plenty of vocal there from Chloe, as you can hear, that you come here, command. Sweeping turn out of the tunnel. Out the ground, around to 14, pushing the dog out to 14. Picks the dog up, comes down to 17, he's sweeping around to these weaves now. Giving the dog a bit of a straighter entry into the weaves, which is no problem at all. We want to clear, and we're going to get one. We are 35.907 into second place, obviously. So, Dave's back, Dave Munnings with Boos, Border Collie Cross Corgi, 5 years of age, Boos the rescue, and has had five homes. He's incredibly naughty and loves to test my patience as a dog trainer on a daily basis. But he's also a hilarious character and he lives for his agility. And these two are flying. I didn't see much of that dog going in the tunnel. Wow, just to the top of the tail. Head must have been straight up there. Difference with Boos, that's probably the tightest turn round 14 I've seen. He's down. He's got his head down. He's going for it. He's keeping up with Dave, and the leg acceleration's coming through now to go. 32.210 goes into first place. Super run. Next to go, Dawn. Dawn Weaver working Cherry Mini Poodle. Cherry's lively and fun and cuddly. She's also loud at times. It's because she came from the USA. Okay. So, Dawn and Cherry. And they're away. So, nice start so far, flowing nicely. A little bit of noise there from Cherry, but not a great deal. Thoroughly enjoying what she's done to number 10. Sweeping out of the tunnel. Working her way now towards the second of the rigid tunnels. Another tight turn, smaller dog see. There we go, coming down to 17. Flowing nicely at the moment into the weaves. Great entry into the weaves, super set of weaves again. Dawn swap inside with one to go. Yeah, 34.923. Into third place for Cherry and Dawn. Come on, Selena, they're saying. It's Selena Bryan next working Raid. WCS, 5 years of age. Raid is a pet person, very much loved. Her favourite treat is egg custard tarts. She's a cuddly, soft, quiet dog until she sees agility. These two are working nice to start with. Dog's really low down to the ground, concentrating on what we're doing. Flowing beautifully so far. Good tight turn there. We saved a little bit of time there. Not a lot, but just a bit. Lost a little bit there, unfortunately, though. No. Oh, oh, oh! So unlucky. Dog just literally came over that jump there, saw the finishing line, and was gone. I did say that here, Selena Cole. Give her a big round of applause, anyway. Unlucky there for Selena and Raid. So, Selena's been in, now Alan's in. Alan the dad. Alan Bray with Takita, working Cocker Spaniel, 4 years of age. Just love this little walker to bits, she says. There you go. I must admit, over the last, well, yesterday and today, I think working Cocker Spaniels have certainly gone up in agility competitions because I've seen more than I ever have done at Crufts. I must admit, competing in the agility. Oh, that was an interesting entry. Oh, well, Alan, you just spotted that in time there, Alan. Did just spot in time. Bit wide on the turn. Speed will pick it up, though. Nice. Nice. Slow it nicely into the weeds. Here we go. One to go, and he's finishing 35.719. Gone into fourth. Look out for the agility later on. So, next to go, we've got Lauren. Lauren Langman, working Blink, working Cocker Spaniel, 6 years of age. Alan just said he's too old for this. A dream dog and part of Team GB, loves water, food, tennis balls, and is crazy to work. Squeaks when he's excited, loves hotel life. Can't wait to get back to the spa. Now this is fun, remember this from yesterday? This is one that is seriously, seriously rapid. There you go. I don't think I need to say much on this one, do I? All I can say is so far, this is rapid. I think the time's gonna be exceptionally good. And we've got two to go. Wow! 32.971 into second place. What a super little dog there, Blink and Lauren. So, next we should have Dawn Weaver working Summer. Collision Collie Cross Papillon, 6 years of age. One word sums her up, wild. Don't know if that's Dawn or Summer. She runs fast and crazy. She air snaps at imaginary flies when she's excited before she runs, and I'm totally in love with her exhilarating craziness and wild streak. Whoa, that was tight. Look there. Yeah. Oh, she worked that well as a handler. Nice. Oh! Dawn went left, I think, possibly. Maybe just lost a dog in the corner of her eye. So we've got the elimination push. So, coming down the finishing line, now give her a big round of applause. It was a great run up to that 1 point in the middle there. Unlucky there for Dawn and Summer. So, next to me, we have Tony Dawkins, working Sunflower, Mini American Shepherd. 5 years of age, Sunflower's favourite pastime is sleeping in the sun. Just make sure you've got sun cream on. So. Big recall. Yeah, nicely handled. Nicely handled. Whoa, just saw the back end of the leg going in that tunnel. That literally was round there, headed, and away you go. Lost a little bit on that turn there. Not a lot, though. Come around a 12, making our way to the next of the rigid tunnels. Coming down with 17 with 3 to go. Hit Louise in about 29 seconds. Can she go in the first place? We need a clear though, I know that one, that's for sure. 34.933 and goes into fifth place with Tony and Sunflower. So next to go, we've got Sarah Roots working Hiccup, working Copper, 7 years of age. Hiccup has an awesome character and loves everything she does. This is our last dog competing in this competition. And then we'll have a presentation, so if you want to stay ringside and give them a round of applause, you're most welcome to. So, Hiccup's away, Sarah's away. You can see different handling methods there, ran with the dog. Gives her a chance to then stay in the middle of the arena, I suppose. Dogs in the tunnel. In the second of the tunnels in the competition. Plenty of vocal there from Hiccup. Well, she did say round, 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 but obviously the dog didn't pick the jump up, which is a shame. So we've got 5 faults there, unfortunately. Which is a shame. She's given the can, and the dog didn't pick it up, so we've got another refusal as well. So that's 10 faults at the moment, with 1 to go. Big round of applause there for Sarah Hiccup. Unlucky on that run. Stay with us ringside. More agility coming up in the arena very shortly, and also a presentation. And thank you very much for being here while I'm here as well. See you shortly. And presenting today, it's Mr. Martin Cabell, our judge. Thank you, Martin, for stepping in and doing the presentation for us as well. We start off with the small dogs first of all. In first place, what a run, Dave Munnings with Boost Bite. And what a boost it was.
Good boy.
And second was Lauren Langman with Blinking Brilliant at Devonshire.
I loved it, screaming.
And in third place was Nina Rajala with Best Start at Zanimos. on to the mediums. In first place in the mediums, it's Natasha Chambers with Northern Indiegogo. Second was Dawn Weaver with Galaxy's Ace of Spades. And in third place, Ashley Butler with Eliza Dulots of Aspen. And moving on to the large dogs. First place in the large dogs was Come By and Away, Ready Eddie Fame with Dave Muddings. Second was Come By and Away, Redefined with Dan Shaw. And third was Avon Wolf, Beanie's Dizzy Dora with Jessica Clairhow. Well done, everybody.
Well done.
Just take the glassware off them. And here we go, we're on lap of honour time.
For your puppy at royalcanin.co.uk.
I am Heating Louise McMullen, and this here is a retired police dog Hall of Fame. I must have been knocked out, and my initial thoughts were, as I opened my eyes, was seeing the flames because the car had caught fire. I injured my wrist, fractured eye socket, fractured jaw. I just knew I had to get him to the vets because I thought he would die.
My name's Hayley, and this is my dog, Ellie. When it happened, it just felt like my world was falling apart. I just thought, I just can't do life without her. Ellie stepped up straight away afterwards. She was my rock, and she just followed me everywhere. When I'm training with her, it's like I forget about everything around me. She just gave me something to aim for in life. I owe Ellie my life, because she's just one incredible dog.
I'm Sean Laidlaw, and this is my rescue dog, Barry. I took a contract out in Syria to disarm bombs out there. There was this kind of concrete plinth, and that's where Barry was, just kind of caught in there to try.
Because we've been through so much and we've gone through such a traumatic event, I think we've formed a lifelong friendship that will never be changed. I am PC Louise McMullen, and this here is a retired police dog, Wolfie. Specialists told me that I would never be an operational police officer again, not only a dog handler. I wasn't going to listen to that because I'm quite stubborn, and was adamant I was going to get back.
She just kept like striving and making little steps at a time. And it was quite a long journey really for her. Just showed that desire, like, I am not going to be told I can't do it.
So with the support of West Midlands Police and my inspector at the time, I managed to get back to being a fully operational dog handler.
Wolfie and her immediately connected. As soon as they got together, it's as if they'd been together as fun puppies. I think they only did a 2-week rehandle course and then went out back out on the streets operational.
I must have been knocked out, and my initial thoughts were, as I opened my eyes, was seeing the flames because the car had caught fire. I injured my wrist, fractured eye socket, fractured jaw, and I also sustained quite bad injuries to the centre of my back. As I was crawling out the car, my only concern was that I had to get the dog out the back of the vehicle.
I got there, I could still see some smoke or steam billowing. Louise was on the floor with Wolfie.
I just knew that I had to get him to the vets because I thought he would die.
He's not just a dog, he's a colleague to us. Not shy to say that it was emotional.
I was in hospital then, just being apart and not able to be near him was horrible. He had to be carried out of the vets. He couldn't walk. He had hydrotherapy. He also saw a physiotherapist there. He's also helped me because I had a bad back and I was limited in how much I could do walking. So the two of us together must have been a right sight to see. Wolfie passed his license again in the May 2019.
And they proved that they were very capable of going back out there and going back out on the streets. However, Louise quickly identified some of Wolfie's behaviours, that he wasn't actually happy in the vehicle.
We had a really busy set of night shifts, and I think it took him back to that November. We put it down to the fact that Wolfie is suffering from post-traumatic stress. Events such as the accidents that we've been through not only affects us, but it also affects them. My instant decision was to retire him from police work. Our friendship has grown even more in the fact that we spend more quality time together now, I think. It's sometimes nice to sit, have that companionship and that affection and love from them to make you smile.
What Leo loves is to be able to get to know a patient. You know, we walk down the corridor and people say, "Hello, gorgeous," and he looks up, and I'm sure he thinks his name is gorgeous at times. I'm Lindsay Uglow. I'm the lead therapy dog handler of the team that visits Southampton Children's Hospital. SCH Therapy Dogs is Southampton Children's Hospital therapy dogs, so we're a team of 6 therapy dogs and 4 handlers.
The minute Lindsay and the dogs walk on, people switch off, people have time to relax. The patients that are awake absolutely love the treat of having a dog. It's somebody who's non-clinical can come in and just offer them something that we can't as staff. They bring a bit of home into the unit, into what is a really clinical, intense environment.
I knew nothing of his diagnosis or his condition, and then it was suggested that maybe I should introduce the dog to Oscar.
Lindsay brought Leo over, put his paw onto Oscar's bed, and instantly his heart rate dropped and we got a smile. And it was a miracle, it really was.
If we can give them that little bit of magic to cling onto, then that's really great. That smile meant a lot to everybody. All of what we do comes under animal assisted intervention. So within that, there's animal assisted activity, which is meet and greet. They'll go and say hello to everybody. They're like speed daters. If we're doing an escort, or if we're supporting a child who's having a particular procedure done, we might be sitting with that parent and child for 40 minutes. And it's all about keeping the child with a positive thought process whilst they're having healthcare.
Leo just comes into the unit, he's such a chilled dog. Just having that calming time, just patting Leo, is just therapy for us all.
They're greeted by people from the minute we walk in the door to the minute we leave. He will trot in like he's owning the place, but to try and get him to leave, on occasion I've actually had to carry him out. The dogs just come in and their friendly faces, they give them something other than the healthcare environment to think about. They're not there to persuade or cajole the children, they're just simply dogs. And we are the bridge between the healthcare team and the child.
Ellie is my absolute life. She's just my rock for everything. She's just my constant sidekick. I probably wouldn't be here, to be honest, if it weren't for Ellie. My name's Hayley, and this is my dog, Ellie. When it happened, it just felt like my world just falling apart. We was all sitting here as a family, and she went upstairs and she said she'd be back down for lunch, and she never did. We were best friends, and she was my biggest support network, and she was my idol. All my family had someone to talk to and someone to share their grief with, and I didn't. Not have her there in my life, I just thought, I just can't do life without her. Ellie stepped up straight away afterwards. She was my rock and she just followed me everywhere. Our bond just grew stronger. She just stuck by me. Like, she knew what was going on. She just would put her head on my lap if I was feeling sad at the time. If I just wanted to cry, she'd be there with me. She just lay by my side. It was like she was saying that everything was going to be okay. Ellie was my motivation to get up in the morning. She was my motivation to get out of bed and get dressed, even if it was just to come and feed her. But she'd get me up, she'd get me walking, which in turn got me socialising straight away and talking about what happened. And she got me back to what I love doing, which is agility and Hearworks music. We go agility once a week and we train Hearworks music every day. We train tricks at home, whether it be out in the park or in the living room. When I'm training with her, it's like I forget about everything around me. We go to compete every couple of weeks or so. We go to local competitions with agility and we travel up and down the country for Hearworks music. When we go to shows, it's like being in a bubble, just me and Ellie. Nothing in the world matters. It's just me and her spending time together, training and enjoying ourselves. Being able to take home a rosette, it's good to be able to look back and see the journey we've taken together. Ellie was the reason I carried on my activities such as agility and Hearworks music. She just gave me something to aim for in life. I owe Ellie my life because she's just one incredible dog.
Agility is a sport for athletes.
Yes.
So, have you done any training to prepare yourself for this feat?
Zero training today. I go to the gym about once a year.
Once a year? Oh my God. Okay. So that might not be enough. I don't want to worry you. But have you warmed up outside?
No warm-ups just yet. Shall I give it a go right now?
I think you need to do a bit of limbering up.
A few stretches.
A few tricep stretches there. Well done.
Yeah. The legs as well.
Yeah, the legs as well. There you go. So, ladies and gentlemen, do you think he's ready to have a go? I think so as well. Okay, so we have a wonderful assistant, Natalie here, who's going to help Dave get his mum's dog, it is actually, I believe. No, his mum does agility, yep. Sorry, it's not his mum's dog. Sorry, Dave, do apologise. So, first of all, Coco is going to go through the tunnel and then over the jump. So come on, Dave, give us your best. Here we go.
Sit.
Like it, bit of control to start. Goes down well.
I've never done this before, so wish me luck. Here we go. All right, tunnel. Over the jump.
Yes! Well, that's a great start.
Go, go.
Call her back. She's like, come on, why have you stopped? Well done.
Okay, that was a warm-up.
So that was really good, Dave, by the way. Good start.
So now we're doing the full course?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay,
here we go.
Do a course
sit.
Now. Right, now, can stretches. I just point out the obvious? The dog's facing the wrong way.
Which way? The tunnel?
Yeah, you might want to just right, turn their left a little bit. Yeah.
Sit. Right.
Well done. Oh, not sure that's going to work.
Coco, this is a start. Right, sit.
Well done. Yourself.
Right, that's the best we're going to get. I'll do a few stretches. Right, here we go.
Okay, yeah, he's limbering up, look.
Pressure's on here.
The pressure is on.
Come on, Coco, we've got this.
She's like, I'm ready.
Right. Tunnel. Jump. Tunnel.
Come on, ladies and gentlemen, let's give him
Coco.
A big round. Oh,
come
think
on.
She missed that. Let's give him a lot of encouragement.
Coco, where's she gone?
No. Coco, come back.
Coco, come here.
Coco. Go on, go, go, go.
Loads of people watching
well
us.
Well done.
Coco, come here.
She's like,
tunnel.
Who's got the yes. sausages? Yes, give right. him a round of come applause, on. Ladies
jump.
And gentlemen.
Jump.
Let's cheer them on.
Jump. No. Coco, come back.
Yeah, she's like, do it backwards.
You know what? Jump. Jump. Tunnel.
Yay, well done. Oh, change direction.
Jump. Jump over here. Is it me doing something wrong or the dog?
Yeah. Dog's doing great.
Coco, jump.
That's it.
And over the next jump. No!
I'm not sure over the next one is a command
I
really,
much better than
might
this.
Understand, but.
Oh no. This is not going too well.
Weave. Here we go.
Weave. No one noticed that one. Weave.
Our judges weave. Said you got 5 falls. Weave. Weave. Brilliant.
Oh, we'll take that. Coco, this way. Coco!
Coco, come back. Go, there you go.
Good jump.
Here we go, A-frame. Over the A-frame, ladies and gentlemen. Yo!
Go on, jump.
Round
you got
to
this.
The left.
You got this.
Onto the dog walk.
Dog
come
walk.
On.
Yes.
Come on,
come
Coco.
On. To the
come
finish.
Come on, Coco. Yay.
Hey.
Well done. That was amazing. Woo. That was brilliant. Oh, my goodness. You broke out into a sweat. You've broken out into a sweat and you've only done, what, 5 obstacles?
Did she do well then?
I think she did brilliantly.
No one noticed at all, did they? The little mistakes.
No one noticed. I think you got away with it.
Yeah, yeah, just about.
Oh, I think she's coming back to see you, look. That was amazing. Did you enjoy that?
I'm out of breath now.
I know, see? It's not easy, is it?
But I had good fun. And yeah, hopefully we'll be invited back next year.
we may
fingers
well see you. Yeah. We may well see Dave in the Crufts singles. What do you reckon, ladies and gentlemen?
Probably not.
I think so. Good sport, no. Well done.
Thank you very much.
Really
thanks
good.
For having us.
So let's give Dave Goodies from Capital FM. If you want to listen to him, he does the Drive show on Capital FM in the afternoon. So thank you very much, Dave. I'm going to now hand back to Nigel, who's just going to start us on our medium team final.
Okay, so welcome back. This is it. I think someone needs a course time over here. So welcome back to the main arena. And we have... Okay, we have a judge. So put your hands together, please, Mr. David Isbister. He's our judge this morning, I should say. David, good morning to you. So we've had Martin earlier on. This is the Crufts medium team. I'm starting it off because Kate's just got to pop up and see somebody for a minute. And our first team is the ESSC mediums. Team of 4 dogs, obviously small dogs. Team of small dogs, medium dogs, sorry. Sorry, I don't lie. Medium dogs. Baton change when they've done the course. So they start on number one. They're going to work their way around the course, come over the last obstacle, and they'll do a baton change. If they drop the baton, they get penalised with faults. I think it's about 100. So in an ideal world, we want 4 clears. It does happen. Last year, I think I commentated on 3 different teams that actually all got clear. So it can happen. We've also got Martin Neary in the ring as well. He's going to be doing the contacts as our second judge. So David's the main judge. Martin will also put his hand up if he thinks it's a contact miss. And it looks like we're all ready to go. So Jenny's Hilliard's going first, working Squid, Shetland Sheepdog. Squidgy's first time at Crufts. Hoping he's feeling brave today. He loves running as part of the Sheltie team with his mates. He especially loves running with his litter mate, Blaze. So obviously they need some kind of like a time at the end. It'd be nice if they all went round in really, really rapid times. But to do that, to get 4 dogs round, it does take a lot of doing. So if they get 4 steady runs, they stand a real big chance of being today's winners. We're in the weaves at the moment. Course is working, running nicely. Handled nicely. We've got to switch around now, 15 to go up over the A-frame. If they also make a mistake, they've got to rectify and finish the course. They mustn't finish without finishing the course, if that makes sense. So second dog's away, underneath the card for that one, which is Caroline Durrant. Working Blaze, Shetland Sheepdog, 5 years of age, first time as well at Crufts. He's easily distracted by a crowd and loves to show off his long flowing locks. Big brother to Squidge, a lovely, honest boy to work and live with. So at the moment, they're flowing around nicely as well. And this is the last time that team will be actually at Crufts, so we won't be having large, medium, smalls in the future. I'm sure it's going to be really paced with something just as exciting. So it's a bit of a kind of, it's been a legend for many years. Sam's next, Sam Toe, working Frankie, Shetland Sheepdog, 6 years of age. Frankie's a typically gobby shelter, as we can hear. Honourably following on his sister's Pennies in the shelter team, this will be first time at Crufts. So they're on the green carpet for the first time. Another experience for them and the dog as well. And at the moment, they're ticking along nicely with five faults. Five faults can be a winner. Nice set of weaves. Swings the dog round for 15, up over the A-frame. Across to 17, working away now down to the middle towards the finishing line with the dog walk. Nice contact with the target command, and we're switching over now to Rhiannon Thomas, working Sully, Shetland Sheepdog, 6 years of age. First dog, they've got an elimination, unlucky Rhiannon. Well, I remember years ago, I was part of a team, we had a flowing three fast jumping rungs. I was fourth, I was the anchor man, as they say, and unfortunately I got us eliminated. I never heard the end of that for years, but I'm sure Rhiannon with her team will, without a doubt, take something away from this. With a bit of luck, she'll be back here again with another team, but unfortunately it won't be here, it'll be somewhere else, because the teams won't be here, as I've already said. I'll get it right in a minute. Obviously there are team events, other events around the UK as well, so I'm sure there'll be somebody doing team. So, unlucky with the elimination. So that is the SSC medium team. First ones to work their way around the course. Next we should have Whirlwind Wigglers. That takes a bit of saying. So a team of four again, the Whirlwind Wigglers. First stop to go will be with Sandra. Sandra Jones, working Luna, Border Collie, 7 years of age. So Sandra says that Luna's a seven-year-old Border Collie, first time at Crufts. She's taught me so much. I never know what she's going to do in a ring, and she hopes she behaves. So, Sandra Luna. Nice steady start. Bit of vocal as well, bit of vocal as we go across towards number seven. So no problem with the contacts on the up or the down if you haven't seen them before. Obviously there's an up contact in white and a down as well. And the dog needs to make contact with the up and the down and also be under control as it leaves the obstacles. So A-frame next. And that's then followed by the dog walk. So, nice steady run there with Sandra and Luna. Next in we should have Michelle Patient with Winnie, working Cocker Spaniel, 4 years of age. Work still in progress to do a full course, if it's breezy. Okay. Winnie is 4 years and Springer Spaniel. We're very privileged to show her crazy girl off on the green carpet. So at the moment, working around nicely. Nice bit of hand in there as well. Down towards number 13. And unfortunately, we've gone over 17 the wrong way around, so we have an elimination, which is a great shame. But as we've already seen, the other team previously got eliminated. Now, for instance, you may get every team eliminated. Hopefully, we won't get that, of course. And it would be the fastest eliminated team. So that's why we continue scoring and marking as they go around. So next to go, we should have Caroline Green, working Rosie, working Cocker Spaniel, 8 years of age. Rescue dog, grade 7 agility dog, third time in the Crufts team, she also enjoys competing as fly ball as well. So we're in the weaves. Nice set of weaves. Quick Turn around in front of the dog, round for 15, up over the A-frame. And on to the dog. Nice, nice touch command. We got the touch as well. Well done. And last to go. Well, it's Mike. Mike Ferrer. I've seen Mike for many, many years. And he's got an elimination. He's working Ting. Excuse me, a border collie. Ting's also qualified for the YC as the, well, as the team. She's bred by a good friend. Ting is a very friendly, licky dog. So, A-frame coming up.
On it!
Finishing on the dog walk. On it, the commandment across the finishing line. Unlucky there with some eliminations in between. And I'm going to pass you over to Kate now, and she'll take over with the team from you now. Thank you very much.
Okay, so Omni Dogs are the team that are in the arena. And they are ready to go. Our first handler is going to be Wendy Gilpin with Brooke, the working Cocker Spaniel. And it's not easy getting four dogs round clear in a team event, especially with all you lovely people watching. So let's see what the Omni Dog Mediums are going to be able to do. This is a Nilu Celtic Mist, is the dog's full name. Round the back there. Down, crossing sides as the course turns right into the weaves. Nicely done, but just comes out of the last pole there. So she has to correct that, because if she doesn't, then that would mean an elimination. So well done for going back and correcting that. And here we come down this final line onto the dog walk. She's crossing sides so that she can have an easy baton change. And Wendy is going to take the baton from Ruth Bates. And this is Kiwi, the working Cocker Spaniel. All things nice, Kiwi Spice is her full name. Onto the seesaw, has to hit the ground, well done. A little bit of a detour, picks up five points there. Oh, and elimination, just went into the tunnel. There were so many options there. There was people and there was obstacles and all sorts.
Wait.
So, got to carry on. So, I believe that might be a disqualification. I need to check that signal. So that means that's a disqualification. So what that means is, because she didn't complete the weaves and she carried on in the team, you have to complete the course even if you're eliminated. So this team has been disqualified. But this is Rachel Bunce. She's going to have a go anyway. This is Trevor, the Chinese Crested Powder Puff. Leap Whacker Clever Trevor. Nice turn there. And Trevor is no stranger to Crufts. He's been in the juniors in previous years and competed in all sorts of agility-related competitions. So he's putting in a good run as we go round onto the dog walk. Crossing sides there so that she's on the right side to collect the baton. And she's collecting the baton from Sarah Bunce. And this is Jay, the crossbreed. 9 years old this dog is, so agility keeps our dogs fit, it keeps us fit as well. And J2O is his full kennel name. And he was rescued actually at 5 months old. And probably her last time competing in the main arena. Nice weave entries there. Sarah crossing sides, onto that A-frame. Round onto the dog walk. And a lovely finish. Picks up 5 points, but that's probably immaterial. But well done, Sarah. So well done, the Omni Dogs. Well done. Ah, we have some support. Possibly because they're north of the border from Scotland. Yeah, love it. I love the fact that you've brought your own fan club with you. So here we go. This is XL Dogs, Dog Agility's medium medley. Bit of a mouthful, but it works. And this is Derek Elms with Kia. Calderwood Charmer, 9-year-old dog. And a rescue dog, actually. Second time at Crufts. All picks up 5 on the seesaw. But we're okay. We haven't got a team, I don't think, that hasn't been eliminated yet. So 5 faults would be good. There we go. On to the dog walk. Picks up 5. So we're on 10, but that's still okay. Takes the baton from Abigail. And bounce, Abigail Titley with bounce, the Staffy cross whip it.
Good,
yeah. Little lady
go on,
bounce.
Go, tunnel. Good girl.
And she's a rescue dog and can be a little nervous, so she's doing absolutely great in the main arena here.
Yeah.
She says, I'm just careful, I'm just making sure that everything's right. Lovely. Into the weave poles. Yay. There you go. Oh, no, she said no. Not sure today. Gonna have another go. So we're on 5. She can do it. She can do it. So we're on 15 as a team. Over and round to the dog walk. Just managed to get on there. Picks that up. Well done. Well done, bounce. And the baton has been taken, and this is Lorraine Murtar with Inca. Practically perfect Inca. Picks up 5 for a refusal. 15, that makes us on 20. 20 faults. And this is another rescue dog, actually. And she also does rally and fly ball, so multi-talented. Nicely into the weaves there. Crossing sides. Oh my goodness me. That was close. That was close, but well recovered. So, on to the dog walk. Make sure she gets it. Well done. Well done. Okay, last to go in this team. We've got a miniature poodle. It's very noisy. Loki. Hotspot trickster. Says he loves to run on the beach. And part of the winning team, I think this team did very well last year, 2019. Nicely in there. Here we go. Wow, look at those. Very nicely done. Ran onto the A-frame. We've got 4 obstacles to go. Come on, Loki, onto that dog walk. And picks up 5. Picks up 5. So a total of 25 at the moment, yeah. Oh, we had a baton fault as well, noted by our judge. So we will work out the scores for that. And they add 20 faults for a baton fault. What that means is that there wasn't a clean exchange. The baton, for example, mustn't be dropped and things like that. So a total of 45 penalties for that team. But it actually puts them in first place because they were the first team to not be eliminated. So that's really good. So, all still to play for. We're ready with our next team. This is Charlie, the Jelly Babies. Chris Durrant is his handler.
Charlie, come.
And... So they know, they don't want to get eliminated. Oh, okay, so that was an elimination. Took the wrong course, and I believe that's a disqualification. Okay, so again, I think probably because he didn't go back round and take the correct course, I would imagine that's why that's been disqualified. Our judge is nodding at me, that's good, got that right. So that's why that disqualification happened. Okay, so Chris is going to take the baton from Julia.
Here, Charlie.
Julia Durrant with Bay. This is a crossbreed before anyone else. Is the dog's kennel name. So down the line, across, changing sides there into the weaves. Just make sure you don't take the back of the cross jump. Nicely through there. Oh, making sure she doesn't do that the wrong way. There you go. Nicely done. And we've got four to go. Checking the up. Checking the down, well done. Over the finishing line, well done. Julia takes the baton from Donna Lewis, and this is Jelly Bean. And under breed it says here, guess. So, answers on a postcard, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, good boy.
We could run a competition, couldn't we? What's Jelly Bean's breeding? Well done.
Go, 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 go.
Nicely done. Over that A frame. Oh, picks up five. Oh. I think Donna's got this there. There we go. We're back on track. There we go. Picks up another five on there. And takes the baton from Simon. This is Simon Cowley with Avon. Crossbreed. 10.5 years old. Agility's great. It keeps all our dogs fit for function. Keeps us fit as well. And it doesn't matter, it can be a pedigree, your dog can be a crossbreed, a rescue. Just go and talk to the Kennel Club, get your dog registered if it isn't already, and you can enjoy all of the activities that you see here at Crufts, the Hewitt music, the agility, obedience, canny cross, everything. So Avon says, I don't like the weaves today, Dad. Well done. Just correcting that.
Tilt.
On to that A-frame. Four to go. This is the last dog in the team.
Yay.
And woo! Over the final jump. Well done, Simon. Unfortunately, that team picking up a disqualification. So we've got three teams to go. Another one from Scotland! Woo! This is Dag Dag East Just a Smidge. Wow, that's a great team name. Jane Dalton's going to be running first with Roxy the Crossbreed. Whiskey on the Roxy. First dog, proud to have reached grade 7 in agility, qualified for Crufts. Another rescue dog. So what a great outcome for these dogs. Starting off in a rescue home and ending up in the main arena at Crufts. Just fantastic. All very nice into those weaves. Crossing sides to block the wrong side of that jump there. Nicely along onto the dog walk. Gets that very nicely. Okay, it was a clear round. That deserves a massive round of applause. And we have taken the baton from Sharon Pedley. And Kim, the working cocker, 4 years old, Killington Kim. Nicely onto the seesaw. Wow, right to the end. That's a great seesaw. Blind cross. Oh, keep going, right turn. Into the, oh, very nicely done from a distance there with a turn at the end. Come on, Kim. Over that A-frame. Round onto the dog walk. Fabulous. Over the finishing line. Two clears. Okay, so Pamela Whiteman with Smidge, another working cocker, 5 years old, Ken Quince Magnolia. Working gun dog this is, so a multi-talented dog. Obviously leads a very active life. Into the weaves, nicely done. out the other end, pulling and flicking back over number 15. Here we go. Making sure she gets that touch point. Fantastic. Wow. Okay, so it's all down to Elizabeth Graham and Willow the Shetland Sheepdog. So in agility, we call this the anchor dog. And that's because they have much of the pressure, especially if the rest of the team has gone clear. So down the line, into the weave poles. Come on, Willow, over the A-frame. We've got three to go. Onto the dog walk. Ooh, yes! Well done! Woo! Four clears! Well done! Oh my goodness! I think we were all living that dog walk, weren't we? Oh my goodness. Almost didn't have even a toe on it. The whole arena went quiet. Oh my gosh. Whew. Well done. Well done, ladies. Fabulous effort. Four clears, obviously, go into the lead. So a time of 1:57.085 to beat our new leaders. We've got two teams to go. Oh, goodness me. That was edgier seat stuff, wasn't it? So on the line. This team is Agility Club Blue, Cockers and Crosses. Tells you what's in the team, I think, in terms of breeds. This is Jill Payne with Boots, the working Cocker Spaniel. Give it some welly, Boots. It's her kennel name. Picks up five forks there for the long jump. And just taking out one element there. So we're on five. Slicing down that jump. Oh, just saw the back of the Crufts jump there, so picks up an elimination. So onto that old walk. And well done, Jill. Jill's going to be taking the baton from Sandy. This is Sandy Candy with Joey. And this is a Jack-a-poo. So that's a Jack Russell cross a poodle. And Joey actually lives with Sandy's mum, but Sandy gets to do agility with Joey, which is quite a nice arrangement. Oh, don't look at that one. Unfortunately, that's an elimination there. Picking up the back of the jump. So on to the dog walk, gets the contact over the jump and takes the baton from Jane Furlong. This is Poppy, so a cockapoo, so Cocker Spaniel Poodle Cross, Potty Dotty Doodah is her full name. Great name, great name. On to the seesaw. Nicely down that line. Oh, well done, well done, well done. Gets her in the weaves. Left turn. On to the dog walk. Nicely done. Oh, clear round, well done. Well done, Jane. And Jane takes the baton from Hannah. This is Hannah Payne, just picking up five forks there. Went round the first jump and a fork there for touching the dog. So in agility, the handlers are not allowed to touch the dog. Once they've started on the course, you're not allowed to touch the dog. So just picked up five forks there, and we call that a flyer, the flying seesaw. That's five forks because it must touch the ground. So picking up a few forks there, but obviously as well, the team has been eliminated. So onto the dog walk. Nicely done. Well done, Hannah. Well done, Agility Club. Agility Club Blue.
Well done, Hannah.
So, last to go. Last to go. in our medium crufts team final. And this is Pause and Connect from Staffordshire. Charlotte Allen is going to be running first with Charlie, the working Cocker Spaniel. Minterburn Charlie Allen at Jasper Thorne Agility Warwick Silver. First time in the main arena. Says he's a very effective alarm clock. So, looking to beat four clears. So I'm sure our team will have had a tactics talk about whether they're going for steady clears, whether they need to go for time. Obviously they do have to be clear first and foremost though. So, over the A-frame. Round left onto the dog walk. Gets that. So we have one clear in the bag. Well done, Charlotte. This is Amelia Nicholson with Willow. This is a collie cross working cocker. Squeaky voice. Little Miss Woo Woo. Nice little dog. Nice into the weaves. Getting the blind in to get round the back. Nicely done. Oh, just picked up. Dog missed the blind. Lovely though, lovely. Well done, Amelia. So just picking up five there for a refusal. This is Jilly Sawyer with TK, Collie Cross Shepherd. Sorry, Shelty, not Shepherd, I do apologise. Quite a difference there, isn't there? Five falls there for a refusal. Well recovered. Made sure the dog didn't eliminate them.
Come,
right
come,
turn
wait.
Into the weaves.
Wait.
Nicely done.
Wait. Walk.
So we're on 10 falls. Make sure she gets the contact.
Yeah. Walk.
Catching up, making sure she gets the other end. Well done, Julie. And takes the baton from Amanda Hampson. So this is a collie cross poodle. CB. Completely bonkers, it stands for.
Beep.
Down into the tunnel. Round the back. Down the line. Nice blind there by Amanda. Keeps the dog on a very straight line. Into the weaves. So I'm going to just make sure I get them all. Onto that A-frame.
Go! Back!
Round to the left, onto the dog walk. Well done, Amanda. It's another clear. Well done. So, 10 falls in total. Well done. Goes into second place. So, thanks to our judges, David and Martin. And bear with us, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be very shortly going on to the presentation. We're delighted to be joined by Ian Seath from the Kennel Club Board, who's going to be presenting our awards. So, ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the Crufts 2020 Medium Team and the only team to have four clears was Dag Dag East, Just a Smidge.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thanks very much.
Well done to you.
Well done.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Very good.
Thank you.
Very good. Well done.
Thank you so much.
And on to our runners up, which were Pause and Connect. Well done, ladies.
Thank you.
Well done to you all.
Well done.
Thank you very much.
Very well done.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
There you
go.
Thank you. Okay, let's give them a big round of applause as they take their lap of honour.
Thank you, and welcome to the Kennel Club's Good Citizen Dog Scheme. And during our opening sequence, you would have seen many elements from the through the scheme, a scheme which comprises a puppy foundation, a bronze, silver, and gold level. And we're going to look at the beginnings, the puppy foundation, the building blocks of our training. So we're going to start over here, looking at taking our puppies over different surfaces. We've got some cardboard, we've got some fleece, we've got a load of different surfaces that we've got to get the dog used to. We're also walking with the dog on the lead. At the bronze level, we start with the dog on the lead. We progress to off the lead walking in the silver and gold level. And we're also looking at basic puppy positions, the sit, the stand, and the down. That's socialising our puppies. Next, we're going to look at socialisation with other dogs. We see our young dogs, first of all, being socialised just with the handler, by hand. And as we progress through the scheme and go through to the bronze and the silver and the gold, it's getting used to being around other people, walking through other people and distractions. And at the silver and gold levels of the scheme, we're also looking at introducing other dogs and socialising our dogs in that way. We're also looking at play in this area, playing with our dogs. There's lots of different ways of play. You can see some of the play here just by using hand stimulation. Some is using toys and rattles and things like that, but we never simulate play fighting. Moving over to our third group now, we're looking at the recalls. We're starting with the puppy recall on the lead. You can see, leaving the dog in a position, walking away a few paces with it on the lead and calling it to you as the dog comes towards you. Going on to the bronze level, where it's held by a loose lead by a helper while the handler goes 10 paces away and recalls the dog. And then when we get to the silver levels and the gold levels, it's rejoining the handler and then rejoining the handler while walking. So looking at various levels of close control in terms of the recall. And finally on this side, the scheme is all about real life. It's all about taking it outdoors. It's what we do every day with our dogs. So here we're looking at a simulated road scene. Of course, we take our dogs for a walk. We're using roads and footpaths. So we can see a number of dogs on the lead, nicely under control, crossing the road, interacting with one another. We've got the nervous dog there. He's telling everyone I'm a bit nervous, so everybody else staying away. Quick impromptu poop scoop in there, because as responsible dog owners, we always carry poop scoops and we always pick up after our dogs. Here we see the dogs now waiting at the zebra crossing. Lollipop lady stopping the traffic. So we've got stops and starts. We've got dogs waiting in different positions and walking through lots of distractions. Now, of course, we mentioned the road. Sometimes we may take the dogs somewhere in our car. We may be going on holiday. It might just be to the local park. So we have to consider vehicle travel with our dogs. So here we see our friends in the car with their dog. Oh dear, these things do happen, but we didn't consider our vehicle travel. We held the dog on our lap on the back seat. Upon impact, the dog has gone flying through the car, through the windscreen, and probably would end up in this fatal situation. So it's not the ideal way to travel with a dog. So let's look at that again and look at the correct way to travel with a dog in a vehicle. So this time Anna Gretz decided, I'm going to put my dog into a cage or a crate in the back of the car, close it. Now it could be that it's an area partitioned off at the back of the car, it could be that it's wearing a harness strapped into the seatbelt system, but off we go again. Can you believe it? They're going to get one of them phone calls later, aren't they? Have you had an accident? But as we see on this occasion, they might be a bit shaken up, the car might be damaged, but the dog stays safe in the crate in the back of the car. Maybe a bit confused, but it's safe. And that's what we want for our dogs. So vehicle control, travelling with our dogs, very, very important to the Good Citizen Dog Scheme. Well done, folks. Now, I said earlier that the scheme is all about real life. It's all about what we do with our dogs out in the community. So here we're going to look at some countryside scenes. So if you're like me, live in the city, it's nothing better than getting out at the weekend into the countryside, fresh air, different scenery with my dog. But we need to consider the environment and everything that's happening around us. So first of all, over in this corner, we've got a duck pond. Ducks enjoying their time on the pond. There might even be fishermen there fishing. And the worst thing that can happen for these ducks or the people using it is dogs rushing in, trying to chase the ducks, splashing everywhere. So as responsible dog owners and good citizens, we keep our dogs on leads when we're around ponds and open water areas like that. We do not let them interfere with wildfowl or anything like that. Okay, so we can see all of our dogs nicely under control, looking at various aspects, but here we have a dog off the lead. Oh dear, and it's gone and interfered with somebody else who was minding their own business and keeping her dog under control, and it's tried to take her dog. Not take her dog, take her toy. So here we can see that the owner of the dog, busy on her phone, wasn't looking at what she's done, just let the dog off the lead, let it run off. It's okay, my dog's friendly. But it's interfered with somebody else and it's upset them. So we always consider our environment and what we're doing with our dogs, making sure we've always got them under control. Now we're going to look at approaching horses. We've got a very lonely looking horse over here. And often when we take our dogs out, we think the best thing to do when there's a horse coming towards us is to hide the dog away, hide it in the bushes so the horse can go past without seeing us. But invariably, we will walk out at the side of the horse just as it's going past. The horse gets startled and the panic progresses from there. So the best way to deal with this situation is actually to walk head on. Let your dog see the horse. Let the horse see your dog. You can then reassure your dog, keep it under tight control, give it a wide berth if appropriate. So very, very well done considering the horse riders. Now, sheep is a problem when we're out and about. Sheep and dogs never mix in the same field. And here we see sheep and lambs grazing, and it says keep your dog on a lead. It may be that there's a footpath that goes through the field. If so, we can use it, but we must keep our dogs on a lead and under tight control at all times. So here we see Bodie and Brian having a walk around the sheep. Bodie's a bit too big and he's knocked one over, but hey, that shouldn't really happen. But the main thing is keeping Bodie under tight control by our side. And if the dog is really reacting to the sheep, we should leave the field. But of course, much bigger than sheep are cows. And cows present a bit of a problem to us sometimes because they're curious creatures. And if we're in the field with cows or we get close to them, they're curious and they'll come over and want to say hello, want to see what you're all about. Sometimes they could be very quick and sometimes there could be quite a few of them. So here we see our dog handlers approaching the cows. But all of a sudden, the cows have started to stampede and run towards them. And the best thing that we can do for our dogs is to drop the lead and run away. We run away to the nearest exit or safe place, and our dogs will follow us. And rest assured, folks, your dog will get there before you do. So we don't pick the dog up, we don't try and rugby tackle the cows or anything like that. We drop the lead and we run away, as we saw in that demonstration there. Well done, guys. Now, there's nothing better after a long dog walk in the country than stopping at the local pub for a bite to eat and a drink. And this is what our dog owners are doing here. So we've got our tables out at the dog inn. Lots to drink. They've actually got human food on the table. It's burgers and chips. It might be a bit cold. But what we're looking for in the Good Citizen Dog Scheme is well-mannered dogs. And here we see a number of well-mannered dogs. They're not jumping up. They're not demanding food. They're not begging. They're a joy to have while our friends socialise and drink and swap stories and things like that. Having had a great time out, left all their leftovers behind, and off they go. So a good demonstration of food manners there. Right, well next we have an exercise that we call send the dog to bed. Now sending the dog to bed is not a punishment. It's a safe place for your dog to be in within your home or your environment. So we're going to do this as a bit of a game. We've got three going at the same time. So handlers, let's get the beds ready. Come on, let's get the beds ready. It's going to be fast. It's going to be quick. It's a competition, folks, so be happy if you want to cheer, shout, clap, scream, sing, or anything like that. Handlers, this is it. Ready? Send your dog to bed. Oh, and it's a win on this side, I think. That's one through to the final. Luna didn't win. Now, there's a surprise. Next three dogs, please. Handlers, send your dog to bed. Oh, somebody didn't want to go to bed. They're enjoying themselves too much. I think a win again on this side. This side seems to be the lucky side. That's two through. Yeah. Got three more. Handlers, send your dog to bed. Send your dog to its own bed. Oh, it's chaos at the moment. Have we got a winner? No. Nobody has gone to bed. I think it's going to have to be Stanley, who decided to remake it and he's still remaking it. Stanley goes through. So that should give us a final, I believe. Sorry, that is it. That was send the dog to bed. Remember, folks, sending the dog to bed is not a punishment. Right, next we were going to be looking at stopping the dog on command and a recall. So let's have all of our handlers back into the ring. What we're going to see here is how we stop the dog from a distance. Stopping the dog at a distance is important because it might be that it's running into some sort of problem, maybe glass or something on the road. Maybe there's traffic about to cross its path when it's returning to us. So we're going to look at that. And then we're going to look at the recalls. So, our two stop the dog handlers are going to leave their dogs and go to opposite sides of the arena. Are you ready? No. Well, to make it more interesting, team leader Jennifer's decided to put a £5 note down on the floor. If one of the dogs lands on it, they win it. No pressure. Right, handlers, leave your dogs. And when you're ready, Hayley, recall and stop. Hey! Stopped on a fiver. All right, that's £5 we owe Hayley. Well, it won't be me, it'll be the Kennel Club. Can Bourbon do it this time? When you're ready, Hev. Oh, we just missed. Unlucky. So that's a fiver for Hayley. Right, next we're going to recall all of our dogs at the same time. Firstly, from the sit. So handlers, command your dogs. Now cross to the other side, please. This is the bit where all the handlers are holding their breath. And recall your dog. Oh, somebody's got confused. No, there we go, yeah. I'm coming, Mum. Yeah, wait for me. I'm old. Well done, folks. But we'll do that again, but this time from the down position. So all dogs in the down. Handlers, command your dogs. Handlers, leave your dogs. And recall your dogs. Well done. Excellent control, excellent weights, and all dogs back to their handlers. Ladies and gentlemen, girls and boys, that almost concludes our very short demonstration on the Kennel Club Good Citizen Dog Scheme. If you'd like to find out more about the scheme, you can, of course, visit the Kennel Club website or find us in Hall 3 during Crufts. But I'll leave the last words to the handlers and the dogs. Ladies and gentlemen, girls and boys, thank you for watching the Kennel Club Good Citizen Dog Scheme.
There we are, the Good Citizen Scheme. Give me a big round of applause. It's a really important scheme. And there's been tens of thousands of people, pet owners, gone through the scheme. It is so important that. And thanks to Mark for a great hosting of the event as well. If you want any further information about the Good Citizen Scheme, if you go up to the Kennel Club stand in Hall 3, they will point you in the right direction, and you'll be told all about it and where you can perhaps go to join a good citizen team to get some training yourself in everything you've seen today. Anyway, folks, we are going to have a short break now, and it's probably a good opportunity for you to follow the government advice and pop in one of the loos and wash your hands, because they've got the right soap in there. I think it's alcohol-based soap to do the job properly.
But we are coming back very shortly, probably just before 12 o'clock, with Heel Work to Music. We had the freestyle competition yesterday. It was fabulous. We've got the Heel Work to Music section coming up today. So do make sure you come back before 12 to get your seat for the Heel Work to Music finals.